Hello and welcome to this video on how to prepare and clean up your data. In our other videos, we show you how to load nice and clean data samples. But in reality, data is almost never complete or without issues. Consequently, in many cases, you'll find yourself spending more time on data preparation than on actual modeling. Here we'll show you some of the great operators available in RapidMiner to help you with this first step of the predictive analytics lifecycle. So let's get started and read a file with imperfect raw data. The one we're using is in the downloadable archive, which you can find on the training video's website, so you can follow along if you want. The file we're using is called rawcustomerchurndata.xlsx. Let's drag and drop the read Excel operator into our process panel, and then we select the data file via the available option in the parameters panel. The data is in the first sheet, and we don't have a date column, so we can keep all the default settings. To get a first look at the data, we connect the output port of the operator to our results port and run the process via the shortcut key F11. You can probably spot some of the issues that our example set has immediately, as we have purposely placed them in the first few lines. In your scenario, it will be certainly less easy to identify problems, so we recommend you start by taking a look at the statistics on your data. In the column Missing, you can see that we have some blanks in the gender and age attributes. And as we click on gender, we see that there are 4 unique values where we should have only 2. A look at the details tells us that there is a single M instead of male, and one of the female entries has some leading blanks. Further, we have some missing values in our churn attribute, and the name Santiago Cruz appears twice, so that might be a duplicate entry which we may need to remove. To make a decision on how to address each of our data issues, we need to consider our overall analytics task first. We want to use the information at hand to find customers who are likely to churn, so we can encourage them to stay a customer. For that, we can use the historical information of those where we know if they are loyal or churners. With that input, we can build a model to make a prediction on the others where we don't know yet how they're likely to behave. So the ones with information on their loyalty are to be placed in one subset to be used as input for creating a model. And we want the ones without churn information to be grouped in another subset so we can predict how they will act. What else? We have some leading and maybe trailing white spaces which we need to remove. And what do we do with the ones with missing or wrong values in age or gender? Let's start with the white spaces. For those, we can use the operator trim, and we'll have that applied to all attributes. Just as a reminder, we're using attribute as term for columns at RapidMiner, and data rows are called examples. Okay, we remove the white spaces, and now we have to decide how to handle the examples with missing age or gender values. Since those are only few, and at the same time the value of attribute would be an important input for building or applying the model, we'll just get rid of those examples by filtering them out. The right operator for that is consequently filter examples. To configure it correctly, we want to select the Add Filters button in the Parameters panel. When we select the dropdown, we can see that it is empty. So to configure our filter, we need to type the title of the attributes in here. Be careful to use upper and lowercase as defined in your example set. But wait a minute, wouldn't it be much more convenient to just select the available attributes titles from the dropdown? For that, the metadata from our file needs to be read. For spreadsheets or CSV files, this happens only if we use the Import Configuration wizard, so let's do that. We select the read operator, and then we just go through the wizard. We'll leave all the defaults, and then we click Finish. If you want to learn more on the Import Configuration wizard, then please refer to the videos on data loading and data import. Now, as we select filter examples again, we see that our attribute titles have been pre-populated nicely for us. So let's add the filters for gender and age and set them both to is not missing. Note here that you can use match all or match any to make one or both criteria necessary for the removal of an example. The next item on our data preparation list is the removal of a duplicate entry. So we'll drag and drop the remove duplicate operator onto our connection, and we will leave it set to all as the attribute filter type. This means that 2 examples are only considered duplicates if they're identical with respect to all attributes values. Before we take a look at our updated example set, let's also fix the issue with the gender value, which was an M instead of male. We'll use the replace operator for that. In the parameters panel, we set up that we want to work on a single attribute, which is gender, and we want to replace M by male. Okay, now let's click Start to run this process and see the data. Oh, what happened here? The gender is all messed up. What happened is this. RapidMiner replaced all the letters M with male. So also the M in male or female. So the only correct example is now the one which initially only had M as value. Before we go back to fix the gender values, let's look at the other issues we addressed. In the statistics, we can see that missing for gender and age are gone, and the duplicate entry has also been removed. Okay, now let's go back to our design view to fix the gender values. We only want to replace the letter M if it is not part of a word. In order to identify that, we need to use something called a regular expression. A regular expression is a special text string for describing a search pattern. You can think of regular expressions as wildcards on steroids. The expression we're going to use here to identify our single letter string is a single M in square brackets. And we will add backslash B in front and after, which marks the beginning and end of the word. So now we're searching for a lowercase m by itself only. If you want to learn more on regular expressions, we recommend to look at www.regular-expressions.info. But there are also many other sites available which will help you get started with this powerful feature. The last items on our list are splitting the data in two subsets and preparing it for the next steps of the predictive analytics lifecycle. For splitting, we can use the split operator, or we can also use the filter examples operator. So we copy and paste our previously created filter example. Then let's adjust the settings to filter out examples where churn is not missing. Now we can use the unmatched port and store these examples using the store operator. I'll save the dataset in the data folder and we'll call it unlabeled customers. Since we have only missing values in the churn attribute, let's get rid of the attribute to save space. We'll use the select attributes operator and we'll set it to select only the churn attribute. Then we tick the invert selection box, and voila, we're now storing our unlabeled data for later. By now, our process panel has been filling up, so we need to get some more room. We can move operators below or more to the right, which will give us a slider, or we zoom out a bit. However, the most elegant is probably to move all the operators which we used for data cleaning into a sub-process. Just mark all the operators, and then we use the right mouse button to send them all into a new sub-process, which you can also give a descriptive name if you want. Now we can rearrange things nicely and finally prepare for our remaining example set to become our training data. For that, we will remove unnecessary information first, which in our case, the names. Again, the select attributes operator with the invert selection will do the trick. In order for the model to know what is the target variable, or as we call it, the label, we need to use the set role operator. So let's drop that on our connection and set it to make the churn attribute the label. The attribute will now be automatically disregarded for building the model, but will be used for validation. Now, as we finally connect the store operator to the results and select the Run Process button, we see our two fully prepared subsets in the results view with the label identified in green. The next steps, like building and validating a model, are shown in other tutorials, so we are ending this tutorial here. We hope you enjoy this video in which we showed you how to clean and prepare your data using some of the many operators available in RapidMiner for data preparation. Thank you very much for watching.